Hello everyone, welcome you back for this session on the inchworm linear motor. Now in this session we will try to discuss the two different types of inchworm linear motor where the movement is taking place in a linearly. This it can be achieved by using the piezo ceramic crystals or the piezoelectric materials, normally the crystals. In the inchworm linear motor, as the name itself is suggesting it as something like a worm. Why it is called as a worm means, in the inchworm linear motor, the movement of the shaft or it may be the piezo ceramic itself is the linear in a slow motion. Normally where and which is taking place in the case of the worms, that especially either it may be in the earthworms or it may be in the caterpillars. The piezo ceramic inchworm motor is a linear motor generally used in a micro position application due to their ability to make the accurate movement. There are two clamps are there, one and three are the actuators. Normally we used to call that as a clamps. There it has been typed as a 2, but it is a 3. The another one is a extensional actuator with the actuator of 2. The clamps are designed to work on the central rod. The movement is achieved by coordinating the activation of the clamp and as well as the extensional element. Now the working principle of the inchworm linear motor will be is as follows. In the case of the clamp 1 is turned on, which grips the rod, the clamp 3 is turned off, which relaxes the grip of the rod, and the extensional actuator, which is nothing but the 2, is turned on, where the extension is taking place in a linear way. The movement of the, what we can say, the shaft is taking place to the left side. Depending upon the direction, even this it can be reversed also. If the same is repeated in a reverse way, the rod can be moved to the right hand side. The sequence of repeated for a many times and the rod can be moved to the left or right depending upon the activation. Now the schematic diagram shows the three piezo ceramic materials. The another one is nothing but the shaft. 1 and 2 are the clamps or the actuators. The 2 is nothing but the extensional one. I will repeat the things. The first one as well as the third one is the clamps, and the second one is nothing but the extensional actuators. 1 and 3 will holds the shaft and releases the shaft depending upon the direction of the motion, but in the case of the 2, the extension is taking place in a linear way. Because of the movement of the 2, the linear movement, it may take place either it may be to the right side or it may be left side depending upon the type of the application, or even it may be in a continuous motion also. The inchworm linear motor, using only the property discussed so far, it is possible to describe the operation of the realistic piezoelectric mechanism shown schematically in a figure as an inchworm type of a linear motor, which consists of an H made of the three piezoelectric stacks. Each stacks are made up of the several PZT elements that expands or contracts in the response to the applied voltage to produce the axial motion at the end of the stacks. In this configuration, the stack 1 and 2 cause the expanded to clamp against the wall and the channel walls of the channel. The another one, 3, is an alternative one which expanded and as well as contracted for the linear motion. By the properly synchronizing the voltage applied to the PZT stakes, the H may be made to move either the direction in the right side or it may be to the left side along the channel. To produce this motion in the direction indicates, the signals as shown in may be used, causing the armature of the motor to advance in steps as shown in the figure below. The velocity that can be achieved depends upon the rate at which the control of the electronic can be generated and needed signal, and on the axial displacement of the motor achieved in each steps. For example, suppose each PZT stakes is 1 cm in length and made up of material with a piezoelectric modulus of 600×10^12 mV, and that the controller can generate a 2000 outputs changes per second at the voltage sufficient to produce a field of 500 kV per minute in the actuators. From the timing diagram, it will be seen that each steps through a full range of stacks of three will be requires a 6 controller action, so that the motor armature can be advances the rate of 333.33 steps per second. Now, this is a schematic diagram of the inchworm linear motor, where the three stacks is there. One is nothing but it is in the form of a H shape. The representation of the H, two vertical columns, the 1 and 2, is also a piezoelectric material. Even the third is also a piezoelectric material. The 1 and 2 expands and as well as contracts in the vertical direction, but in the case of the third one, it is linearly expansion is taking place. Because of that, the motion it is taking place in between the channels. The schematic diagram shows the movement of the, what we can say, the H-shaped inchworm motor. In the first one, where it has been explained as the 1 and 2 expands in a vertical way and the third one is in the linear way. In the first case, the voltage is not applied, but in the second case, the voltage is applied on the number 1 PZT. Once if its voltage is applied, the contraction is taken place in the step 2. Then automatically in the piezoelectric crystal of the 3, if the voltage is applied, the linear movement is taking place. Because of the linear movement, the 1 has been shifted for a small length. Then automatically in the step 4, again a small voltage is given for the 1, it expands. Once if it is expands, it will be gripped in the channel, where the head shape has been increased. In the step 5, what will happen if a small voltage is given to the 2, automatically the contraction is taking place. Once if the contraction is taking place, means the gripping action between the channel of the 2 has been reduced. Then again, if a small voltage is given in the step 6 for the 3, then automatically the contraction will take place in the linear movement. Because of the contraction of the piezoelectric 3, then the movement is taken place in the PZT of 2, where the movement is taking place. Put together is nothing but the displacement where it has been measured linearly, if you start comparing between the 1 and as well as 7.